Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from reasoning from the topic ranking. So it is an important topic for your RBI Grade B prelim examinations. Also this topic is also important for SEBI Grade A and NABARD examinations. So friends, if you like this video then do subscribe to our channel. So let's begin. So question 1, in a class Seema is 10th from the top and Bubbly is 20th from the bottom. So before discussing the question, you must know one simple concept that if you are given a position of a student or a person from bottom as well as from the top, because a person can be given a position or rank both from the top as well as from the bottom, or both from left as well as right. So if you are given the position of a person from two ends, like from both bottom as well as from top, then you can find the number of persons or students in the class or in the queue or in the list. So let me give you an example. Let's suppose a person is ranked 15th from the top and the same person is ranked 10th from the bottom. So you can now find out the number of persons in the row or in the queue. So the number of persons in the queue will be 15 plus 10 minus 1, which comes out to be 24. So what I have done, I have added the position of the person from top and bottom, or you can say left or right, and I have deducted 1. That gives me the number of person or students in the class or in the queue. So this is the formula, simple formula. So now let's discuss the question. So the question says that Seema is 10th from the top and Bubbly is 20th from the bottom. So if I talk about Seema, the position is 10th from top and Bubbly, she is 20th from bottom. So which means if Seema is 10th from the top, it means 9 students are ranked above Seema, right? And if Bubbly is 20th from bottom, it means 19 students are ranked below Bubbly. So this is simple. Now the question is saying Raju is 11 ranks below Seema. So Raju is 11 ranks below Seema, which means it's 10 plus 11. So Raju is 21st from top. So the rank of Raju is 21st from top. And it is also given that Raju is 21 ranks above Bubbly. So if Raju is 21 ranks above Bubbly, it means the rank of Raju is 20 plus 21, 41st from bottom. So we have got the rank of Raju from top also and from bottom also. So now we can easily find out the number of students in the class. So the number of students, it will be 21 plus 41 minus 1, which comes out to be 62 minus 1, which is 61, right? So the correct option is option B, 61. Now let's move to the second question. So the question says ages are to be computed in whole numbers only and no two persons are of the same age. The question further says Mahesh is a year older than Vikas. So Mahesh is older than Vikas. Vikas is 2 years older than Jagan. So Vikas is older than Jagan. Here the age gap was 1. Here the age gap is 2. Next, Jagan is 1 year younger than Suresh. So you can also say that Suresh is older than Jagan by 1 year. Then Suresh is 2 years younger than Mahesh, which means Mahesh is 2 years older than Suresh. And finally, Akmal is 2 years younger than Jagan, which means Jagan is 2 years older than Akmal. So from these two, we can see that Vikas is 2 years older than Jagan and Suresh is 1 year older than Jagan, which means Vikas is older than Suresh, who is older than Jagan. And the age gap between them is 1 year, right? And you are given Mahesh is older than Vikas. So Mahesh is older than Vikas. So we have covered this, this and this. And this Mahesh is older than Suresh by 2 years. It is automatically covered. You can see Mahesh is older than Suresh by 2 years. And next is Jagan is older than Akmal by 2 years. So Jagan is older than Akmal by 2 years. So we have got the relation between the 5 person. So the order is Mahesh, Vikas, Suresh, Jagan and Akmal. So you are asked to order them from oldest to youngest. So the correct option is option C. Mahesh, Vikas, Suresh, Jagan, Akmal. Now moving on to the third question. The question says, in a queue of children, Kashish is 5th from the left and Mona is 6th from the right. So let's write down Kashish and Mona. So the question says, Kashish is 5th from the left. The position of Kashish is 5th from the left and the position of Mona. So this is their original position. And the position of Mona is 6th from right. So this is their original positions. But we don't know the position of Mona from the left and we don't know the position of Kashish from right. This we don't know. And the question says, when they interchange their place among themselves, Kashish becomes 13th from the left. Which means if Kashish goes to the position of Mona, the position of Kashish becomes 13th from left. Now if you analyze this very carefully, this 13th from the left is actually the original position of Mona only. So this 13th from left is actually the original position of Mona. So now you know the original position of Mona from right and you know the original position of Mona from left. So now you can easily find out the number of children in the queue. So the number of children will be 6 plus 13 minus 1. It comes out to be 19 minus 1, which is 18. So the number of children in the queue comes out to be 18. Now we have to find out the position of Mona from right. So the position of Mona from right will be actually the original position of Kashish from the right. So now you can calculate this position by the formula. So the formula says position from left plus position from right minus 1 is equal to number of children. So R comes out to be here 14. So you can say that this is the position of Mona from the right after swapping or after interchanging their position. So this is position of Mona after swapping or after interchanging. Or you can also say this is also the original position of Kashish. Original position of Kashish. So the correct option is option B, 14th. Now moving to the next question, question 4. So the question says, Mohan is 13th from the left end in a row of children. Here is Mohan, who is 13th from left. And Prabir is 12th from right and 18th from left. So there is one Prabir, who is 18th from left and 12th from right. So you are given the position of Prabir from both the ends, left as well as right. So you can easily find out the number of children in the row. So the number of children will be 18 plus 12 minus 1. So 30 minus 1, which is 29. So the number of children in the row is 29. Now you are being asked that how many children are there towards the right of Mohan. So first of all, we have to find out the position of Mohan from right, which we can easily find out now because we have got the total number of children in the row. So the position of Mohan from the left is 13 and the position of Mohan from right, that we don't know. So let's say it is R, and if we subtract 1, we will get the number of children, which is 29. So if we solve this equation, we will get R as 17. So the position of Mohan from the right is 17th. So 17th from right. So if Mohan is 17th from right, then it means 16 children will be towards the right of Mohan. So 16 children will be towards right of Mohan. So 16 children will be towards the right of Mohan. Why? Because Mohan is himself 17th. So if I show you, let's say this. So this is right and this is left. And I'm saying that Mohan is 17th from right, which we have calculated. So it means 16 children are there towards the right of Mohan. So the correct option here will be 16. So you are not given 16 in the option. So the correct option is option E, none of these. Now moving to the final question, question 5. So the question says, in a row of girls facing north, Rinki is 10th to the left of Pinky, who is 21st from the right end. So let's draw a row. So let's say this is a row of girls and they are facing north. So they are facing north and this is right and this is left. Because if they are facing north, then their right will lie here and their left will lie here. So you must understand this thing very carefully, because if the question would have said that they are facing south, so if the question would have said that they are facing south, then right would be here and left would be here. The position of right and left will get interchanged if they are facing south. So you have to be very careful regarding the direction. So now the question is saying that Pinky is 21st from the right end. So this is the right end. So Pinky is, let's say this is Pinky. She is 21st from the right end, right? And the question is saying Rinky is 10th to the left of Pinky. So let's say Rinky is here. So she is 10th to the left. So if we plus 10, which it comes out to be 31. So Rinky is 31st from the right end. So Pinky is 21st from the right end and Rinky is 31st from the right end. And the question is saying there is one Minky also who is 17th from the left end. So there is one Minky who is 17th from the left end. And Minky is also 4th to the right of Rinky. So here is Rinky. So the question is saying Minky is 4th to the right of Rinky. So if we minus 4 here, we will get Minky. So Minky is 27th from the right end. Because 31 minus 4, 27. So Minky is 27th from the right end. So Minky is 27th from the right end. So here we have now got the position of Minky from right end as well as from left end. So now we can easily find out the number of girls in the row. So the number of girls will be 27 plus 17 minus 1, which comes out to be 44 minus 1, which is 43. So the correct option is option D, 43. So there are 43 girls in the row. So friends, these were some of the important questions from the topic ranking, which comes under the section of reasoning. So these questions are important for your RBI Grade B as well as SEBI and NABARD examinations. So I have tried to explain you these questions in a very simple manner so that you can solve these questions in your examinations in the least possible time. So friends, if you have liked this video or have learned anything new from this video, then do subscribe to our channel to get more notifications and updates. Prepare well, work hard. All the best for your examination. Have a nice day.